Welcome to the third video in the acontis EC Engineer tutorial video series. Over the course of these videos, we will cover a variety of topics to help you get started with and use EC Engineer. In this video, we will walk you through creating and then modifying an EtherCAT configuration by connecting online and scanning a local EtherCAT network. Before we get started, first, let's review the physical network that we have connected to our computer. First, we have a Beckhoff EtherCAT coupler, which allows us to connect a variety of different digital and analog I/O slices to the terminal block. At the end of the first set of slice I/O, we have an EtherCAT extension unit connected to another coupler, followed by another terminal block of various digital and analog I/O slices. Now that we understand what we have physically connected to the computer, let's get started with EC Engineer to scan this network and build the configuration. The first thing we need to do for online connections is to make sure we have an appropriate driver installed that enables EC Engineer to access the Ethernet controller. EC Engineer supports NPCAP in WinPCAP compatibility mode, and just recently released in version 3.2, we now also support our own NDIS driver. We recommend using the new NDIS driver, but we will also include a link to NPCAP in the description below. The NDIS driver is included with the EC Engineer installation, but you do need to install it separately after installing EC Engineer. Browse to the location where EC Engineer was installed. By default, this is Program Files, x86, acontis Technologies, EC Engineer. Here you will find a folder named NDIS, and you can install the appropriate driver for your system, either the 32-bit or 64-bit driver. After clicking through the installation prompts, note the path where the driver will be installed. Once the driver is finished installing, open up EC Engineer. Since we already have slave devices connected locally to our system, we will select Online Configuration and choose a Class A featured master. In the highlighted area titled Slaves Connected to Local System, select the link layer driver you wish to use, and then the network adapter that is connected to the EtherCAT network. Note that you may have multiple network adapters on your system. Once that is all done, click the Select button to scan the network. EC Engineer comes with an EtherCAT Master built in, which enables this ability to scan for devices and even operate the whole network, which we will cover in a subsequent video. If you encounter problems with scanning, most likely due to issues with the network adapter, we have a Frequently Asked Questions section in the manual, which covers some common problems and how to fix them. In the left-hand Project Explorer area, you will see some devices were discovered during the scan. Change the view to Topology View to see all the devices that were scanned and discovered. Now we are able to configure the slave devices according to our needs. Please check out the other videos in this series for more information about configuring the network. Here we will just make a simple name change to the first coupler, labeling it Axis X. Now we will save the project. At this point, you may be done with your configuration and export the ENI file, but we will go further and show how to modify or enhance the configuration by connecting some additional slaves to the physical network. Let's go back and review the physical devices we have connected to our system and how we will change it. Here is the initial set of devices that were connected to our system. Now we will connect a set of additional slave devices by connecting a cable to the second coupler. Back in EC Engineer, to discover these new devices, we could go to Network, Scan EtherCAT Network, but this would cause all modifications we previously made to the configuration to be lost. Since we don't want to lose that, we will scan for the new devices in a different way. Instead, go to Network, Edit Topology, and then click Scan from this area. Doing it in this way will preserve the current topology and show the new devices that were discovered in the recent network scan. We can then decide if we want to include those new devices in our existing topology. choose the appropriate slave device from the current configuration, and add in the newly discovered slaves to the configuration. Click Apply to accept the changes. Now we have enhanced our existing configuration with the newly added slaves without losing any of the changes we previously had made. We can now export the ENI file and save the project. Thanks for watching, and hopefully you now understand how to build a configuration with EC Engineer by scanning locally connected slave devices. In our next video, we will cover how to create a configuration with slave devices based on the Modular Device Profile, or MDP. So please subscribe to our channel to be notified when we post our next videos, and as always, if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions for videos that you would find helpful, please leave them below, or you can contact us on our website.